Well, there is no end in sight to the soap opera playing out in Monroeville, one of the largest municipalities in the region, and some call it stunning circus politics.
And the latest drama involves alleged harassment. And tonight, both sides go on camera to tell their side of the story to Channel 4 Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram.
This is Monroeville Municipal Secretary Lynette McKinney sitting in as interim municipal manager for the second time in as many years. And this is Monroeville Mayor Greg Arisenko. She filed a harassment claim against the mayor last summer. McKinney says the mayor chastised her for talking to someone he viewed as a political enemy, and that was followed up with several other threats afterwards.
That if I continue to speak to that person, that it would be not in my best interest politically and for my job.
McKinney says the mayor threatened her on several other occasions. In the harassment claim, McKinney quotes the mayor saying, "You better fly under the radar or you may not have a job at the end of the year. And I'm going to take your head off."
If I had done any of that, she would have came forth with a complaint a long time ago. No, again, I categorically deny any of that.
Fast forward several months to 2013 after the municipal manager resigns. McKinney is now interim manager. A motion is made to increase McKinney's annual salary to $86,000 now that she is no longer secretary. It's vetoed by the mayor. Is this an act of retaliation by the mayor because McKinney filed a harassment claim against him?
It is possible, yes.
You strongly believe that?
It is possible.
But Arisenko says his veto was not an act of retaliation. He says there isn't enough in the budget to pay a $67,000 severance package for the outgoing manager and an $86,000 salary for McKinney.
It had nothing to do with the complaint at all. There's nothing in the budget for it. And that was the whole issue for the veto. It had nothing to do personally with her at all.
But Arisenko and McKinney do agree that this latest drama does put a spotlight on Monroeville government for all the wrong reasons.
I wish it would stop.
It's not a good way to represent our community now.
Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.